folks, Will from MinIO here with a how-to on downloading files from MinIO using our Python client API. And in this video, we're going to be using Python 3.9. The MinIO Python client API is actually compatible with 3.7 and above, but we're using 3.9. Also, we're going to be connecting out to play.min.io, which is our online sandbox where anybody can work with the MinIO platform. And we're going to be running all of this out of Visual Studio Code. By the end of this video, you should be able to be comfortable with the fgetObject method, as well as being able to check the results that come out of that fgetObject method. Since we're downloading a file, it should be fairly easy to check whether or not the file was downloaded, but you can also get some additional information from the fgetObject return. Let's take a look at our code. And here I've imported MinIO and also my MinIO demo functions. The main method I'm using out of there is the playConnect method, which gives me a client so that I can talk to play.min.io. And the code that I'm actually running today is going to be the fgetObject method, and I'm also going to show you some results from that. What I'm going to be downloading is from our Python demo bucket. It's a hello world text file, and I'm going to be downloading it here locally to temp downloads, a file called new text. That's the basic information you need to hand to fgetObject in order for it to actually do something. There are other variables you can add in if you have server-side encryption turned on or you need to get a specific version ID. That's also information you can also include in the fgetObject. But for now, let's go ahead and run this and we'll show you what we get. So if I run this with Python 3, demo py, it has downloaded hello world text with the e tag and the version you see there. That tells me that I know what object that I downloaded is the object I was expecting if I'm doing hash codes or something along those lines. And also that version ID, if I want to download a specific version, I can go ahead and grab that version ID and I can add that in. So that would be adding another field here, version ID, and give it that string. There we go. So if I now run this a second time, I will get the same version again. And again, part of my PlayConnect is actually uploading a version of Hello World text for me just to make sure that it's there when I go to run the demo, because play.min.io, the data gets deleted or collected at random times. I can't ever tell when it is. So being able to download a specific version becomes very important in an environment like that. So let me show you the file we actually downloaded. If I do a cat on the temp downloads new text, what do I get? I get some output. It's just a text file based on the Bob Ross Lorem Ipsum, and that gives me some random text to show out here. You have to allow the paint to break to make it beautiful. There isn't a rule. Just practice and find out which way works best for you. Just practice and find out which way works best for you is handy advice for anybody coding in Python. It certainly is handy advice for me. I hope you'll take that advice to heart as well, and I hope you've enjoyed this little how-to. If you'd like to reach out with us, you can contact us using any of the methods you see here on the screen. You can also chat with us interactively on Slack at minio.slack.com, or you can just leave a comment here on the video. Thanks, and we'll see you for the next one.